Welcome, heart friends. Welcome, spiritual warriors. Igor would like me to discourse with you, overshined by him, to speak on the subject of spiritual warfare. Now, we don't like to talk about war and warfare because, as spiritual people, we like to be invested in peace. Yet, there are times when we must engage in a very directed work, spiritual work, which is like that which transpires in warfare, where we have strategies, where we have the outcome that we desire, which is victory, and the pathway to that victory, which must be manifest through the delivery of our heart's fire, our will, and the trajectory of our spirit as minutemen and women of the masters, as warriors of truth, justice, the power of God manifesting as God's will, which is very forthright, which is very intense at times. And so this warrior attitude in a peaceful way is important for us to understand and at times engage in order to have our victory. We are not spiritual wimps. We are advocates of the highest outcome for our planet and the way in which we live, move, and have our being with the intensity of our virtues shining through us, the immensity of God's light flowing through us. And because we are virtuous beings and we are warriors of the spirit, this engagement with God is something that is important for us to understand so that we do not lose sight of the victory of the mission of the Universal White Brotherhood, its purposes, the dynamics involved in that victory, which do require the calling to task of the liar and his lie, or her lie, and the invocation of justice, which at times can manifest as judgment or as mercy. Justice is blind, we know this. Blind to what? Not blind to the truth. Justice is blind in the way that all justice is outpictured with equality toward everyone. And so those who seem to be the lowliest receive the same type of justice as those who seem to be at the highest echelons of power. And we have seen, of course, this discrepancy manifest in our civilization, where those with power and money and influence hold sway to the point where they don't answer for their crimes and for what they do. And yet those who do not have those resources often are beset by what can be an injustice of the justice system. As spiritual warriors, we lock into God's will every day by asking God to fulfill God's purposes within our lives. Because we do not, from the human vantage point, always know, through our lack of vision at times, what the highest road and pathway may be, what the best opportunities that we can engage in are, And so we must always sublimate our will to the higher will of God and allow God to authenticate that will through our lives by virtuous action, by concerted effort, by a very directed stream of God beingness that flows through us as purpose, as dedication. And through that purpose and dedication, victory. We have seen a recent election, and many are now wailing publicly as a result of the outcome. Why? They don't like the outcome. Yet this is what the American people, based on our system, have elected. The whiners exist in many realms. Those who are passionate in one sense, based on their own perceptions, and yet often live in an illusory world of Maya. They are not always awake to the higher realities that heaven is attempting to manifest upon earth in the ways of God, in the ways of virtue, and the ways of spirit. And so we as spiritual warriors must take to heart our commission to be virtuous at every cost, to be loving, compassionate at every turn, to be understanding and kind and noble no matter what is thrown our way, no matter what we encounter on our path, no matter what others do or say to us or about us, that may not be the truth, kind, or honorable, and yet we, because we are true, kind, and honorable, accept those slings and arrows of outrageous fortune and move on our sacred journey to the light, to our victory, to our divine destiny. Igor would have us know that during great times of peril and stress upon the earth, it requires initiates of the sacred fire to stand firm in their resolve to be arbiters of the divine destiny of God in this world, to be advocates of truth and justice and freedom, even if it means that we ourselves are enslaved by a system that is cruel toward the human, toward people, and toward God's will upon earth. This civilization as a whole lives in Maya and in darkness. And we must be that light. We must be beyond illusion, living in the pure spheres of spirit while we yet are embodied upon earth in order to be exponents of truth, justice, freedom, liberty for all, equality of opportunity, though there will never necessarily always be parity in all realms because of people's karma, because of their past choices, and the way that the law of the one, the law of the circle, the law of karma, works out injustices that we have wreaked in past lives upon us now so that we can learn our lessons. So there is not always parity or equality in the human condition based on past choices. We must understand this, even as we are always merciful toward the downtrodden, the meek, the humble, the forgotten, loving them, serving them as best we can. And how do we serve them? At times we do feed them personally, and yet for us as initiates, we serve them through the dynamism of our prayers, our calls, our invocations, our devotions, our intense and yet gentle meditation upon and with God, We always remain in the center of beingness, harmonious, true to our cause, noble in our endeavors. There is not one iota of the fabrication of nonsense and of human limitation in our consciousness that keeps us bound to unreality or a less than consciousness. God is our employer. God is the cosmic dictator of our destiny, the righteous type of dictator. God created everything, and we must look to this divine one who created us and give obeisance to our source. Else, we are as human fools, thinking that we can do something better and what is within the divine system that God set up to engage in. Nature speaks righteously to our souls and our hearts. And if we are loving and kind, if we are virtuous and understanding, we take our cues from nature. We learn God's secrets embedded within nature. We follow the natural impulses of light from within ourselves through our intuition, and by listening to the still small voice, and do not listen to the voices of darkness and of the astral plane that tempt us with all manner of illusory opportunities to engage in proclivities that are less than ideal. The dark ones desire the annulment of our soul's fire. The ascended masters desire the ennoblement of our soul's inner light by raising us on wings of light to fulfill our destiny. America, as a great people, a melting pot of many cultures, many voices, is here as an example for all countries of this planet to live in brother sisterhood if we can follow the divine principles and values set forth in our Constitution and our Declaration of Independence and live as free spirits first and foremost, unencumbered by the derisive and divisive forces of darkness that would steal away our inner and outer liberties through all manner of innocuous engenderings of those illusory things that keep us bound to ourselves rather than found in God. Our source is our inspiration. Our God is our example and light. Our Creator is the beginning and the ending of our existence. We began in God, and we will end in God if we listen and obey God's laws, God's voice within us, and God's call to love. The Blessed Mother Mary, when we commune with her in holy prayer, exalts our souls with her virtues and her light by raising us up into that light to feel God's presence, God's love, God's greatness and supremacy of beingness. There is none greater than God, more supreme than God. So why should we accept something less than God's energy, light, beingness within us? By listening to the voices of darkness and watching examples of licentiousness through our media and inanity through what Hollywood and others purvey. Listen to the voice of God within yourself daily and obey the inner calling to a greater enlightenment of who you are, a greater endowment of God's Spirit within you, a greater fire of perception, beingness, and clarity of consciousness that comes because you set your course on the Divine One, and you are true to that course, realigning yourself daily if you temporarily lose sight of the pure vision of your divinity. Grow in goodness in some way each day by self-emptying all that is of the lesser self, and then drinking in the light of your pure and noble divine presence, the I Am God presence, your solar presence of light. It is easy to speak about spiritual things to others. It is much more difficult and challenging to be that reality of the teaching that we know through practical application, through work, service, and desire fulfilled through sacred labor. Completing projects, initiating new cycles of light. If you find at any time that you do not know how to go about doing what you feel called to do, then let go of your own sense of lack or your own sense of unknowing and embrace what is beyond human lack, which is the allness of the abundant life of God, and embrace the knowingness of spirit that flows through you when you are attuned and aligned by a listening ear, a listening inner ear, to the voice of divine reason, truth, harmony, conscience, wisdom. There are many employers in the world who would use you for their purposes. When you are employed by God, God will not ever abuse you. God chooses you as his son or daughter to ennoble all through that light that God invests within you. That investment began at the onset of your creation as a spirit spark and has continued to this day, and yet many have lost sight of and no longer feel that divine spark within their heart. So we must enliven them to feel God's presence within. We have to first be that presence of love to them, a particle of God within us that inflames others, will allow them to in turn feel and fired again, enriched again, enlivened again, and then to work toward their divine destiny of unity with the Holy One. This world is beset by arch deceivers. Many of these are principally within the media, within the banking systems, and within the higher echelons, the military-industrial complex, the international corporations as conglomerates of human power, whose only desire is to control by manipulating our minds, our wills, our hearts, through desire for commercialism, materialism, and things, rather than a desire for virtues, God's essences, God's beingness in our lives. We can have all the things we require that are really necessary for us if we first put our faith in, our attention upon, and our focus, our directed focus on God. Seek first the kingdom of heaven, and all these things shall be added unto you. It's okay to have things that we require. It's okay to have more than we require so we can give away to those without what they require. This is a type of divine capitalism rather than the type that we often see through over-commercialization of everything in our society. Advertising, marketing, left and right, all around. We're bombarded by these images, by these calls to buy, 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 consume, consume, consume. Well, let us buy our ticket to the divine heaven world by being true to the faith of principles, precepts, and divine values. And let us consume light. Let us drink in, assimilate God's virtues every day. Let this be our commerce. And if, perchance, within this movement we offer opportunities for you to feel more of God's presence in your life, then thank us and thank God for this opportunity and what we collectively, our staff, our volunteers, our heart friends, our donors are doing to support this activity and movement. Igor says that it requires every one of us to fulfill the mission of the Universal White Brotherhood. Every one of us, a part of our greater mission, personally is invested in the holy mission of the entire spirit of the Universal Great White Brotherhood. They have a greater vision than we do individually. It's a holy collective vision of inculcation within our world of God's will. The acceptance of that will by every man, woman, and child, and then the dramatization, the fulfillment of that will in reality through conscious works, through directed service, through intentional sacred labor. If you seek to know what God's will is for your life, then get to work every day in some humble way and serve others. Service opens the door to a greater opportunity for spiritual labor. If you're not willing to work, get into the dirt and plant seeds of light, and how can you expect the harvest at the end of the cycle of growth and maturation? You must be willing to get on your knees and pull the weeds out of yourself, of your lesser awarenesses, of your ignorances, of the futility of living and a less than consciousness and in an attitude that you don't have what it takes or that you are not good enough. These are lies of the devil and those voices of the astral plane. You are good enough because you are God. You are God's child. You are God's son or daughter in manifestation. Therefore, you are good enough. God in you is the good. Humanly, none of us. You are righteous. The God light, though, in us is that divine beingness essence that is always pure, real, and holy. We must get with the program. What is that program? It is God's will. When we are right with God, we live in that will. We are blessed by that will. At times we are challenged by that will, and yet we are also fulfilled and that will. So if you desire greater fulfillment in your life, align yourself with God's will. Get with the divine program. Illumine your mind through the study of the sacred scriptures. Give something of yourself that is new and awesome and spiritual and creative every day. Live out of the box of your human mentality and unreality. What is God's club? Well, it's not for the elite of this world. God's circle of oneness is for the spiritual elite who align themselves with God's will and fulfill that will through love and virtuous living. As spiritual warriors, we take to heart God's commands, because God is the greatest general, the commander of all forces of light in the universe. What are those commands? That we love God with our entire heart, mind, strength, and soul. And that we love our neighbor as ourselves. This is the command of the great commander of the universe. And if we do this, we will always live according to the golden rule and be virtuous, loving, understanding, and kind. Igor represents now to us, on the inner, something that we can take to heart and a prayerful attitude to bring God's light and love into our world. So we will close by simply saying, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among angels, and blessed is thy union with Raphael. Holy Mary, Archeas sublime, pray for us sons and daughters divine, now and ever as we meditate with thee. Yes, Mary, we meditate with thee. We meditate with thee. We meditate with thee. O Mother of love and of Jesus, the Christ. As we say these words in our rosaries, as we mean them in our hearts, and as we profess them day after day, they return unto us the gifts and graces of heaven, the blessings of the Spirit, the joys of our Lord. Thank you. God bless you.